Little space here anyway.
Maybe we should think about leaving the motel.
God, not you too. I know Kenny wants to leave. I think that's why he's so eager to get the RV working. But this is a good spot. We're protected, we're close to the drugstore, we have a routine now.
Is the video playing for you guys or not? She'll say I'm live, but...
We should talk about you and Kenny.
What about us?
They're arguing. It's getting pretty out of hand. You know people notice that.
Look, I'm working my ass off to make sure we have a good setup here, and Kenny just doesn't appreciate that. All we need is food.
But there is no food. You know that better than anyone.
Well, we'll just have to find some.
Keep an eye out.
Fine.
Here, Clem. You need something to eat.
I love apples. Thank you. Are there more?
No, honey. That was the last one.
Oh.
Enjoy it. You deserve it. Hey, Doc. How about a little food? Here.
Yeah! Oh man, I'm so hungry!
How you doing, Clementine? Everything all right?
Yeah. Is that man going to be okay?
I'm not sure.
I hope he will.
That thing doesn't work anymore, does it?
No, not since it broke at the drugstore.
Just gonna hold on to it then?
Yeah, if that's okay. I need it.
It's okay, huh?
You said you didn't think they would find us.
Well, yeah, but that's just because...
But we can try to find them.
Look, Clementine.
Hey, I'm not what's up, Bird? I know it's just pretend, but it makes me feel better.
Okay, you take good care of it then.
I will.
You'll be okay over here?
Uh-huh, I'll be okay.
You were pretty brave when we brought those people in here.
That's because I know Mom can fix him.
How you doing, Doc?
I'm okay. Me and Clementine are coloring. Guess what it is?
I don't know. A dog?
Nope. Oh, I know. It's a goat, right? No.
Catch you later, Doc.
Bye, Lee.
A goat? Really?
Hey, is my friend gonna make it?
I don't know, but Kaja will do her best. I promise.
I can't believe we just left Mr. Parker there.
I tried. I really did. I just ran out of time. There was nothing else we could do. How you holding up, kid?
I keep wondering if I could have done something to help, you know? Some kind of... I don't know. Something.
I'm sure you did all you could.
Yeah, maybe.
So who are you people? Our group's gonna wanna know.
I'm Ben. Ben Paul. The guy in the truck is Travis. He played in the school band with me. Mr. Parker was the band director, but... God, I can't believe we left him.
Relax. We'll get your friend back to
normal. You're not giving him enough food.
I sure hope so.
Carly?
Sleeping any better?
No. I know we should be grateful for beds, but no, I'm not.
Drugstore?
Yeah.
Want something to eat? Here.
Me? How about you? You look like crap, Lee. When was the last time you ate?
I'm okay.
I want you to have this, okay? in case you or Clementine starts feeling weak. I know I said it didn't matter why you saved me instead of Doug, but...
You don't owe me anything, Carly. Lily has me handing out the food.
Ugh, that can't be an easy job.
It's not. I won't be able to feed everyone. What should I do?
Well, if you wanted to get in good with Lily, I'd make sure Larry gets some food. You know that guy can be a real dick sometimes. On the other hand, giving that food to Kenny and his family might make him remember you, if he decides to take off in that RV one day.
What about you? You need food too.
We all need food. I can't tell you what to do, but whatever happens, I know you'll be trying to do the right thing.
Thanks, Carly. Back in a bit.
I'm gonna take Larry.
Word's getting out that you want to leave the motor in.
That ain't no secret, Lee. It's probably our best bet. Look, you've been good to me and my family. You saved Duck from those monsters, and you stood up to Larry at the drugstore. I won't forget that. You and Clem are welcome to come with us.
Coast does sound like a smart idea. Maybe that is the best thing.
I know that it is. I'm taking my family.
Want something to eat? Here, Kenny, take this.
How about my boy? He eat yet?
Yeah, I gave him something.
Sure, then hand it over. I'm starved. Thanks.
One piece left. What should I do, guys? Should I give it to someone else or should I eat it? Let me know in the comments. Give it to someone else. Someone else.
All right. Some of these people have gone longer than me without food. They're the ones who need it.
All right. Well, there's two or three other people, I think. I don't want to give it
to... How's it going, Lee? From up here, it looks like you're playing favorites.
Oh, shut up, lady.
How you doing, Clementine?
Okay.
Where's your hat?
I don't know. Can you help me find it?
Sure. When did you lose it?
I had it a couple days ago.
I promise. If I find it, I'll let you know.
Thank you.
Hey, Nova.
Okay, Clem. I've got to take care of some things. Why don't you go back to playing with Duck for a while?
Okay.
That was creepy. It's inside her head.
Here, eat something.
Why don't you give it to Duck? I'm a little busy with your mess right now. I need space, Lee.
Cranky, cranky, jeez. Try to feed the lady and she just bites my head off.
Sturdy. But it's not gonna hold up forever, just like the rest of this place.
Well, who's these two guys?
Will you hold the damn board steady?
I'm trying. I didn't realize I was getting this weak already.
What do you want? A handout? I got 60 cents in my pocket. If you'll shut up and quit being such a
jerk.
Pansy.
I'm feeding him, for sure. He's too much of a jerk.
Hey, will the kid make it?
I don't know.
You know it was an accident, right? I didn't mean to shoot him.
I know. It was crazy back then. Kid acted stupid. You ever miss the Air Force base? I mean, this wall isn't exactly military standard.
No way I'm going back there. You saw what it was like when you guys picked me up. Completely overrun.
Lily's pretty pissed at us.
Well, what did she want us to do? Just leave a couple of teenagers to the walkers?
That's exactly what you should have done.
Here, eat something.
Thanks, Lee.
Need any help with the wall?
Nope.
Actually, we could use your axe. You mind if we take it?
Yeah, give us that thing for a bit.
Alright, you nothing.
Here, Mark, this should help.
Thanks.
Hey, I'm the one doing all the work over here. You didn't think to give me the axe?
Come on, Larry. Cut Lee some slack. He knows you're just out to protect Lily. He told me so. Just like he's trying to protect Clementine.
He... Oh, I just need some food. Going this long without a proper meal make anybody cranky.
Not such an easy job, is it?
Never said it was. I don't envy you. I don't know how you have the strength to do this every day.
I don't have a choice.
Assault the old man.
Thanks for looking out for me and my family. I'm serious about that offer to come with us. You've more than earned a ride on the RV with me. Still, I guess some people aren't going to be happy with your choices.
You're out? What happened to my food?
There's none left.
You keep treating people like this, and your days in this group are numbered.
You're one to talk, old man.
Yeah? Well, I don't see you working on that wall.
Why don't you just leave now?
Ken, Lee, come here, please.
He didn't make it, did he?
He lost too much blood.
God damn it. I'm getting sick of this shit.
Ken, come back. There's nothing...
Let him go, Katja.
But...
He just needs time. It's been a rough morning.
That man you brought, I tried, but he was never going to survive.
Well, at least he's not our problem anymore.
What about the other kid?
Oh.
You okay?
Yeah, thanks.
Why'd you bring him here in the first place, asshole?
Dad, calm down.
You're gonna get us all killed! You said he wasn't bitten.
What?
We asked you point blank, was he bitten, and you said no.
He wasn't!
Well, your not bitten friend here came back to life and tried to kill my wife!
What?
Wait, you all don't know?
What the hell are you talking about?
It's not the bite that does it. You come back no matter how you die. If you don't destroy the brain, that's just what happens. It's gonna happen to all of us.
God help us.
It makes sense. Those first few days, it spread so fast.
Car accidents, suicides. Everything was making more of them.
When I first saw it happen, we were all hiding out in a gym, and everybody thought we were
fighting. We don't want to know about Bird getting his feathers wet.
Jenny Pitcher, I guess she couldn't take it. She took some pills. A lot of them. Someone went in the girls' room the next morning, and... God.
Back off!
Whoa, lady, relax. Me and my brother, we just want to know if y'all can help us out.
I said back off!
Carly.
You're outnumbered here. Just turn around and go back.
Okay, that's fine. But you'd really be helping out a fellow survivor if you could part with some extra gas before we leave.
Why do you need gas?
Our place is protected by an electric fence. Generators provide the electricity.
Our generators run on gas. Look, we own a dairy farm.
I don't trust these guys. Look like mobsters.
Y'all be willing to lower your guns. We can talk about some kind of trade.
How y'all doing on food? We got plenty at the dairy.
Lee, why don't you and Mark check the place out? See if it's legit.
I'm going with you. I got your back if anything seems fishy.
Why don't she go with her dad and check the place out? What do y'all think? Oh, we gotta do
everything. I think we'll stay here. We're starting to develop a good vibe here at the motel.
Good vibe? Well, Christ, Daddy-o, I'm sorry the folks with the food supply and defenses didn't tickle your pretty pink ass.
We need to think like a group, Lee. This affects everyone.
Then we vote. If everyone agrees, then we'll send you guys with some gas to check the place out.
And if we don't?
Then we'll stay in this wretched roach motel with your recreational paperweight over there. Plus, we stay close to Macon where we have access to the pharmacy for Dad. Kenny, Katja?
We go.
Dad?
You betcha, pumpkin.
Carly?
I said we go.
I'm in.
Everybody votes
for us. Offering food. We gotta at least check it out.
Clementine, what do you think?
Lee, I'm very hungry.
All right. Looks like we're going to a dairy.
Hopefully you can trust these guys,
so,
huh?
This dairy. You guys really have food?
Sure do. We lost most of the cattle, but we still have lots of milk, butter, and cheese stocked up.
And with the vegetables we grow, we got plenty of food.
It's nice to get away from that motel for a while. This Lily Kenny thing is starting to get ridiculous. Personally, I'd be happier if you started to take charge more.
Kenny keeps us motivated. He believes in hope and knows how important it is for us not to give that up. I can't fault him for that.
Or maybe you just don't want to be in charge.
Well, not everyone thinks I'm so trustworthy.
Because of your past. Does anyone else know?
Larry knows.
Great. That can't be easy.
Clementine knows. She was there when we were talking in the drugstore. Asked me about it. I couldn't lie to her.
What exactly did happen with the senator?
It was an accident. I mean, I pretty much knew about the affair. Sometimes I wonder if I should talk to the group about it.
You don't have to. Whatever happened before things went to hell doesn't matter anymore.
Not sure everyone would see it that way.
Maybe you're right. Listen, over the years, I've reported on some pretty messed up shit. I've seen situations like yours 100 times. It doesn't have to make you a bad man.
I really appreciate that.
I mean, thank God Lee showed up when he did. Right, Lee?
Yeah, why don't you tell us a little more about yourself, Lee?
Where are you from?
Motor Inn's my home now, I guess.
Well, that place seen better days, huh?
You can say that again.
Y'all seem pretty settled in at that Motor Inn. Who's running things over there?
Kenny's a guy who really keeps a group together.
Don't let Lily hear you say that.
How many people you got over there anyway?
Enough to defend ourselves.
Well, that's good. Getting dangerous out there. Well, you guys know. Well, we'd love to get you all out to the dairy. Like I said, we got plenty of food, and quite frankly, we could always use an extra helping hand.
In the summers, I used to help out on a goat farm.
Yeah, that's great. Everything helps.
Mama's been running the dairy for as long as I can remember, but now it's...
You think you're gonna cut me out of this?
Shit, get down.
No one's trying to cut you out of anything.
You and Gary are always...
I'm so much smart. You know, crossbow.
Those look like the people who raided my camp.
Who are they?
Fuck
you. You knew we were hungry. And you guys were keeping it all
yourself.
There's
only two.
Oh, no.
There's a lot more.
We ate it all. What are you gonna fucking do about it?
Don't worry. Danny and I got you covered if something happens. But let's just wait this out. I hope they move on.
Fuck you! Fuck you! Fuck you!
What about a waste of ammo?
The world out here is going to shit. Come on, let's get to the dairy where it's safe. Here it is, St. John Family Dairy.
I'm curious, if this happened in real life, what's the first thing you guys would go for?
Fence keeps them out?
If the world was going into a zombie apocalypse.
Bugs in a zapper. We're pushing 4,000 volts through that thing with generators and amps.
I'm going to assume that's a lot.
We got kids in our group. Doesn't seem safe to have them near a lethal fence.
Oh, don't worry about that. We got plenty to keep them entertained.
This place looks untouched. You never know, the rest of the world is in ruins.
It's worth protecting. Hence all the juice.
I thought I saw y'all with company coming down the drive.
Guys, this is our mom.
I'm Brenda St. John, and welcome to the St. John Dairy.
This here's Lee. He's been living down at the old motel, round the way.
They got a few more friends staying at the old motel.
Oh my goodness, that place is pretty vulnerable. Have you got someone with survival?
First place I would hit is Walmart. Honestly.
Kenny's working on getting us somewhere safer. He doesn't think the motor inn will stay safe forever.
Sounds like a smart man. Now that y'all are here, we'll make sure you're safe and comfortable.
Thanks for having us. We brought some gasoline on good faith.
We're all incredibly hungry.
These are for y'all. Baked fresh this morning.
Amazing.
Can't get stuff like that anymore. Not without a cow for milk and butter, that's for sure.
Right. Hopefully Maybelle will make it through this bout of whatever she's got and be with us for a good long while.
Your cow is sick? What's she...
We have a vet. We could bring her here. We can help you folks out.
A vet?
Shut up and stop telling people
our prayers have been answered.
Maybe our whole group could come for the day.
Well, how about this? Y'all go get your veterinary friend and I'll prepare some dinner. A big feast for all you hungry souls. It'll be nice to have some folks to help out around here again. Danny, why don't you come help me out in the kitchen?
Okay, just really does.
Why don't I head back with the food and round up everyone for the trip over here?
Might want to take someone with you. Remember, those roads can be
dangerous. He don't look as shady as the other guy.
I can handle myself.
Take this. Why don't you go ahead and take Ben along anyway?
Take care of yourself, Lee. See you in a while.
Mark, Lee, why don't you take a look around? Once you get settled in, I could use some help securing the perimeter.
Is there a problem?
Sometimes the dead get tangled up in the fence before they fry and end up knocking over a post.
Right.
It'd be a big help if you could walk the perimeter.
The zombie cow.
Can learn a little something about our fence. I'm gonna go top off the generators before they run dry. Come get me when you're ready.
You betcha. This place is incredible. It's got food. And that fence? Oh man, that fence. If we play our cards right, this might turn out to be a place we can stay. So how do you want to play this?
Before we can think about bringing our whole group here to stay, we need to figure out if this place is as safe as they're telling us.
Don't eat the biscuits.
Obviously, they think it's safe. But is it safe enough for the kids? I noticed a broken swing over there. Not a big deal, but maybe there's other things not working that we just can't see yet.
And checking the fence perimeter sounds like a decent way to get a good look at their defenses.
All right, I'll keep my eyes open, and you find out what you can from Andy.
Ooh. Too bad it's broken. I'll bet Clementine and Duck would have loved something like this to play on.
Kids used to like that old swing even more than the tour sometimes.
I saw that corn. Well, they ate the corn, huh? I don't know how to have corn.
Mind if I fix it?
Sure, that'd be great. Mama sure does appreciate y'all helping out.
Looks like it just needs a new board for the seat. some rope, make it safe for Clem and Duck, and let the St. Johns know we can pull our weight around here. Is perfect for the swing. This dairy won a lot of ribbons in its day, huh?
This place was my daddy's life. Meant everything to him. You know, when he first bought this place, it was a single-story house.
Is that right?
After us kids was born, he insisted on adding a second floor. Said they had to have room for as many babies as they could have. Mama, he was done after Dan.
My folks stopped after two as well.
Then one day, the world changed.
I saved a bird earlier.
This is all we have left of Daddy.
I was going to shoot it.
That's why we take such good care of it, and why we want to share it with good folks like yourself.
Fresh herbs. I can hardly wait for dinner. Used to have these on the front porch of my house growing up. Hope the noise doesn't attract any unwanted guests.
Well, hi there, Lee. What can I do for you, sweetie?
Can I help you with anything around the house?
I think with Danny's help, I've got things pretty well squared away in the kitchen. But feel free to check with Andy. He's got a lot of weight on his shoulders these days, so I'm sure he'd love any help he can get.
Your family's done an amazing job of keeping this place up.
Well, now aren't you sweet? Thank you, Lee. The boys and I have tried to adapt as best we can, but we still keep some of our old routines to help remind us of better times.
When will dinner be ready?
It'd be a while still, but it'd be worth it. Trust me.
How many rooms does this house have?
Rooms? Why do you ask?
Just curious, I guess.
Let's not start thinking too far ahead now. Let's just focus on getting y'all a good home-cooked meal tonight.
Well, if anything comes up that I can help with, feel free to let me know.
Well, Lee, I sure appreciate it.
No problem. Something to cut it down to size. This might make a good seat for the swing. Mind if I use one of these boards?
Already making some repairs, huh? I like a guy who takes some initiative. Yeah, go right ahead.
Little screw sticking out of it.
Like the fence runs around the entire property, not just the house.
Yep, can't take any chances when it comes to safety. Hi.
Hi.
Well, I'm glad you guys decided to help us out. I noticed back in the motel that you folks are pretty well armed. Been stockpiling, huh?
Yeah. If anyone tries to fuck with us, they'll regret it.
Well, protecting your people is important, but in my experience, having that many guns around is when people get dangerous.
can't be the first people you've invited up to the dairy.
Well, no, we've made similar deals with other folks, trading for gas.
Right, Bird.
Ultimately, he
was on his way to prison, I'm gonna say.
An electric fence is enough to keep out walkers?
Walkers? Is that what you call them? That's good. The old one wouldn't have, but Mac, he was our foreman. He figured out how to amp it up with the generators. We used to sit out here some nights and watch the sons of bitches sizzle and pop when they got too close. Closest thing to entertainment these days, I guess.
These generators are enough to power the whole dairy?
We got lots. We gotta keep trading for fuel as much as we can, but they all work together to do the trick. Like us.
I'm gonna get to know the place for a minute.
Okay, well, we gotta secure the perimeter, so don't take too long.
Yeah, you still gotta go fix that stupid swing.
All right, this shouldn't be too tough.
Well, I'll be damned. Mama's gonna be thrilled to see that old swing all fixed up.
Hopefully our kids will like it too.
Did you say something, darling? Oh, my goodness. Did you do that?
Just trying to help out a bit around here.
You know,
Wolf Girl, this isn't based off of the TV show. It's based off of the comic book.
Seems like such a long time ago now.
Yeah, it does. All fixed. That should make everyone happy.
It should make everyone happy. Yeah. Yeah, make them happy, yeah. Talk to Mark. I still don't know where he came from.
So what have you found out? Is this looking like a good place to stay?
The fence is no joke, at least around the house. I'm looking forward to seeing the rest of it. I'll keep looking around.
All right, keep me posted.
That's all I've got. I guess.
Hi. Mark and I can help you with that perimeter now.
Oh, good. The fence will stop a walker in about 3 or 4 seconds, but it's overloaded if we leave the husks out there.
You know, Mark and I can clear the fence ourselves if you want to stay here and finish up with the generators.
Well, that'd be great. I'll turn off the northwest section, and if you guys could strip them off and look for any weak points, well, that'd be a big help.
Sounds easy enough.
Stay attentive.
Not Chris, thanks for stopping by.
How's the place looking? Is it safe enough for us to stay? If we can?
It's pretty amazing what they've done with this dairy, but let's see what it takes to secure this fence before drawing any conclusions.
I can't wait until everyone's out here. Everyone besides Larry.
He wouldn't be such a pain in the ass if you weren't telling him we were talking behind his back all the time.
I'm sorry, all right?
We'll work it out somehow.
Well, hopefully he'll calm down once he's out here. There's one. Ugh. Lee, it's dead.
Come on, let's push it off. Disgusting. Come on. I'm sure there's still a few more.
Once this fence is patched up, this place will be a fortress. God, can you imagine not having to worry about the walkers anymore?
Yeah, well, it's useless without gas. We might need food, but the St. John's need gas, too.
Not many drivers these days, Lee. We could scrounge up a year's worth of gas, easy. So what's your take on the brothers? They seem to have this place tied down pretty well.
We've got enough people to take this place by force if we have to.
Sheesh, Lee. You sound like Kenny.
There's another one.
I see it. You never get used to the smell, do you?
Nope.
Christ. I can't stop thinking about dinner. Thanks for the rations earlier. It's not easy eating in front of the kids, but it's all that's keeping me on my feet right now.
We'll go ask for more to eat after this is done.
All right. I can suck it up. Come on. I think I see where they're getting in.
Cussing
this one must have knocked it over trying to get through. He's tangled up in there pretty good. Come on, help me get this thing back in place so we can get Mr. Crispy off of here.
I think we'd get better leverage from the other side.
Good idea. Little help here, Lee? If you're waiting for that guy to help, it ain't gonna happen. Come on. Holy fuck! What just happened?
The fences are on.
Why the hell would he turn the fence on? He knows we're out here.
Oh.
What the? Get to the gate! Get down!
You asshole! Jesus! We had no reason! Now you're fucked!
Who the fuck is that?
No idea.
Fuck. Now what?
With the fence on, that gate is our only way out!
You didn't deliver the goods! Now we're gonna take what's over! You really think you're fucking us?
No fuel! Of course.
Get closer! Give it to you! You fuck with us! Now we're gonna take the blame for it!
If we can reach the gift, we can get through this fence and back to the house.
Ah! Shit, that hurts.
I already got one of you. I can do this all day. I see him. Hey, Rat! We had a deal!
What happened?
Shit. It's one of the dead we pushed down earlier. Gonna have to move.
Okay, it has.
You okay?
Yeah. Bear.
The gate's right there.
He did.
Let's get out of here.
Hey, minion. What's up, buddy? Probably put a, like a warning before this thing or something before I stream this vulgar language and gory content.
Wait, what's wrong?
I thought this place was safe.
Holy shit, are you okay?
I ain't okay. You got
they have no right being out here.
Oh my lord, what happened to you, sweetheart?
It was those bastards in the woods, mama. Yeah, I'll be all right once it's out.
Hey, y'all.
Mark, oh my god, what happened?
He got shot with an arrow.
Christ, are you gonna be okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. I should just pull it out.
Oh no, honey, come on. Brenda's got you. Come on inside now. We'll have you all sorted out. Well, you must be the veterinarian.
What kind of shit is this?
We ran into some people on the way up here. Bandits, I guess. I think it was them that attacked us.
They gave us a lot of problems in the beginning, killed a bunch of our farmhands. We were able to get them to stop by making a deal.
You knew about these people?
Food for protection. Not like we had much of a choice, but they did stop hassling us.
Christ, maybe you were right about this place, Lee.
Maybe it isn't as safe here as we thought.
Look, we're sorry. We never had them screw with us like this. Not since we started giving them food. Listen, we may have had an agreement with those people, but we will not stand for this shit.
Ain't no way we're gonna let those sons of bitches get away with this.
You know where these assholes are?
They're hard to pin down, but I think I know where at least one of their camps are. When you're ready to go scope out that bandit camp, come find us.
Bandits? Are you serious? This place isn't safe. We can't stay here.
Not safe? This place is a hell of a lot safer than that motor inn. I think all of us and our guns can handle a couple of punks with bows and arrows. What we need to do is find a way to get our whole group out here to stay. Take this place over if we have to.
Whoa, cool your jets there, Rambo. These are nice people. Let's not do anything to get us thrown out before we eat.
I'm gonna head out and help Dan deal with these bandits. You guys should try to make friends with Andy and Brenda while I'm gone.
Well, that's easy. I got charm coming out of my ass.
Yeah, that's real charming, Dad.
Where's Ben and Carly?
Since Carly and Ben ate some of the food on the way to get us, she volunteered to stay behind and watch the motor in until we get back.
Hey, kids, look what Lee got working for you.
A swing. I love swings, just like at my treehouse. Come on, Doc. Thanks, Lee. You're the best.
Yeah.
That thing keeps the fence electrified. They look happy.
Anything interesting?
I'm just trying to make sure this place is secure, in case we decide to make this a more long-term solution. Except for those people in the woods. Seems pretty safe.
Good to know. Keep your ears open for anything else that might help us.
Did Duck and Katja get here okay?
Well, it wasn't easy. Duck didn't look so good on the walk over to this place.
Well, if everything works out...
Hi, Mia. Glad you decided to show up.
I hope you're right. Duck and Clementine deserve a better life than starving to death at some crappy motel.
How you holding up?
I hope they feed us, Lee. Soon. On the way over here, I was getting dizzy. Hands shaking, cold sweats. Thought I was gonna pass out.
They've got food here.
Yeah, but I'm not just talking about one meal, you know?
I guess, Lily isn't too thrilled about being here.
I could give two shits about what Lily wants. Duck and Katja need food, and I'm not about to sit around that motor inn and watch them go hungry. You're with me on this, right?
Yeah, of course. Lily's judgment is clouded, but you've got a pretty clear head about these things. I'm gonna go have a look around.
Don't wait too long to help scope out that bandit camp. It'd be a good opportunity to find out a bit more about the St. Johns and their relationship with those bandits or whatever.
Right. I'll see what I can find out. Hey, Clem, do you like the swing?
Yeah, it's fun. Thanks for fixing it.
You're welcome.
Will you push me on it?
Sure. Happy to push you on the swing. Mind if Clementine takes a turn?
All right, Duck. Let Clementine have a try for a bit.
Okay.
How are you holding up, Clementine?
I'm okay, I guess. Are you okay?
Yeah. I'm just a little worried about Mark.
Is Mark going to be okay?
You're lucky out there. Could have been a lot worse.
Are you going to find the people who hurt Mark?
Then we have to make sure they don't hurt anyone else.
Be careful. I want you to stay lucky, too.
Ever since I met you, I've had good luck, so don't worry.
Okay.
What do you think of the Darren?
It's pretty. It reminds me of how things used to look before.
Yeah, it does.
Do you think things will ever get back to how they were?
I don't think so.
Oh, Lee?
Yeah?
I miss my family.
I know, Clint. I miss mine, too. Don't worry. We're safe here now.
As long as the bad people don't get me too, right?
I won't let what happened to Mark happen to you.
Promise?
I promise. All right, Clint. That's enough for now.
Okay. Thanks for pushing me.
Of course. It's all yours.
Yeah!
Okay, Duck. Don't pop a gasket.
I'm gonna go over here and check out the barn.
If there's not enough room in the house for all of us, I guess a few of us could camp out here in shifts. If there's not enough room in the house for all of us, I guess a few of us could camp out here in shifts.
Hey, what's up, Thomas? I'm doing better than I was earlier, that's for sure. Hey, I don't care about the power, hey. Let's go up here and talk to these idiots.
Lee, oh my god, I'm so glad you two didn't get killed out there. Do you think Mark will be okay?
Wish I knew, but I think he's in good hands now.
Yeah? It's not too bad?
He'll be fine. I've seen guys go through worse.
How could you all bring us to this place?
Take it you and Kenny didn't exactly make up on the way here.
I tried seeing things from his point of view, having a wife and kid and everything. But gambling with your family's life is pretty stupid if you ask me. Lee, I know you and Kenny are friends, but you recognize that he's not the right person to lead this group, don't you?
Kenny believes there's still hope. Maybe that's what we need right now.
Well, hope doesn't do any good if we're all dead. I'm focused on keeping us alive.
Man.
And not giving my dad food. That was cold.
Well, your dad didn't deserve food.
Hey. Hey, can I talk to you in private for a second?
Okay.
It's been 3 months. Your dad still treats me like I'm some kind of asshole.
Yeah, well, don't expect that to change. That's just how he is.
So, he's the asshole.
Look, my dad can be an ass sometimes, I know that. But he's not a bad guy. He's got a lot of pain.
The real Walking
he's
Dead
been through
game?
So much.
This is the real
lost
Walking Dead game.
Pretty much everything. And it's hardened him, you know? Yeah, he's bitter and hateful, but that's all just to protect himself. And me. All he's got left in the world is me. And that goes both ways. So yeah, he's probably gonna keep treating you like crap, but that's just because he still has one thing left to care about. So don't judge him. And don't judge me for sticking by him. He's my dad. And I love him.
How do you feel about leaving the motor in?
It's a welcome change of scenery.
I don't know. If we'd just stayed where we were, then Mark wouldn't have ended up with an arrow in his shoulder.
Think our little arrangement with them was a good idea?
A little late to be asking that now, don't you think?
Dad's right. Let's just wait for dinner. And then if Mark is feeling up to it, we leave. I don't want to push our luck here.
Now, let's not be hasty.
I'm gonna go check things out.
Just don't get too nosy. These kinds of people are usually pretty protective of their privacy.
Yeah, and we don't need you poking your nose where it don't belong and getting us thrown out in our asses.
I don't like that guy. Whatever. Let's go check out this bandit camp.
Sorry, you almost got killed out there. We should have told you how dangerous it was.
No shit.
You saw what they did to you, buddy. Nobody's safe here until we start to fight back.
But how?
The two of us should go out and do some recon. Then we'll all mount up for some revenge.
Hell yeah.
Who the fuck are these people in the woods?
We don't know. I think some of them used to work at the big box up the way.
Save lots.
Yeah. Anyway, they're nutty as all hell and get mad when they're hungry.
So, are you ready to head out there and find their camp?
Yeah, it'll be a good opportunity to find out a bit more about what we're up against. Let's do it.
I'll stay here and hold down the fort.
Remember, we're just doing reconnaissance for now. No use getting ourselves killed.
Are you going now?
Yeah, I'll be back soon, Clementine.
Please be lucky.
I will.
See anything?
Not yet.
I know it's around here. It's gotta be close.
Here.
Oh shit, you found it? Watch my back, Lee. I'm gonna check out the tent.
Oh, watch your back. Don't you watch my back.
Clear. This camp's too small. Can't be their main base.
That's what I was thinking.
Take a look around anyway. There's probably some shit around here they stole from us.
Empty. But it looks like someone's been eating out of these. Recently. Tent looks pretty new. Anybody inside?
Two sleeping bags. One of them's kid-sized.
Like they were moving a lot of stuff.
What's in the boxes?
They're all from Save Lots.
The first few days they told folks to gather to the Save Lots by the interstate. Anything worth taking?
Not unless you need a bunch of empty cans.
I'll pass.
boxes from the dairy here.
Probably the food we've been giving them. Fuckers cross the line.
Nothing but fumes. Shit. Just water. Nothing. Empty.
What'd you find?
A video camera.
Let me see that.
Battery's dead, though.
Oh, good. What else they got over here? Let's see if we can find anything useful and then get a move on. I see you handled that gun I lent you pretty well. You a hunter?
No, but Lily keeps us all on a regular training schedule.
Lily? I thought you said Kenny was running things back there.
Yeah, but she's got the combat training. Looks like they expected to be here a while.
Your guns down. I ain't
what
going
she
back.
Have
you
had?
Tell him Jolene ain't going back.
Hey, we had a deal. No shooting as long as we gave you food. What the fuck happened?
You had a deal with them. I ain't them. Oh, I know you. I know what you are. And I know what you do.
You don't know me.
Steal my shit. Steal everything from me.
We're looking for the people who attacked the dairy and shot my friend.
I don't know where they are. But they ain't here. So get the fuck out of my camp.
She's lying, Lee.
Now, maybe you didn't hear me last time. When I asked you, sweet, put your damn guns down. You think I won't kill you? I'm gonna take this here crossbow and put a nice sharp arrow right through your eyeball. Or into your goddamn brain. You're not men. You're monsters. All men are monsters. Take what they want and then destroy it all. Take a can of beans. Take a little girl. It's all the fucking same to you.
Where did you get this hat?
The little girl.
You stole it from her.
So what if I did? You stole her from me.
What the hell are you talking about?
You know what? I changed my mind. I'm putting this arrow right through your balls. Yeah, right through. String them up on that tree. Then I'm gonna head down to that farm and shoot every goddamn person I see.
Look, there's two of us and one of you. No matter what happens, one of us is gonna kill you.
Like you could kill me. They couldn't kill me. They tried. Killing everywhere. Take all the dead folks you want. We'll make more. Go on. Tell him, boy. Tell him what you got in mind for us.
Oh. What the hell is that all about?
God damn it!
You straight up murdered that woman!
Hardly. She had a crossbow pointed at my forehead.
I didn't point at you, it pointed at me.
It's a clean shot, though. Right through the forehead. That's good shooting right there. Still, what a waste.
So, that's it. We going back?
If they ain't here, I don't know where they are. And it ain't a good idea to go tromping through the woods looking for them. So yeah, we head back. Once they see this, they'll get the message.
Crossman, Crossman. I suppose they actually used a brand name in here. Come on.
A hell of a ride, huh?
Jesus, Danny.
What? You ain't getting soft on them, are you? Not after what they did to your friend.
You're back. What happened?
Handled it, Mama.
This isn't what Terry would have wanted.
Terry?
My husband. Miss him every day.
Then screw it up for everybody, then. Why don't you?
Oh, calm down, Princess. I'll do it myself.
What's going on with them?
Don't know. Squabbling, looks like. A lot of tension with y'all, huh?
Don't mind them. It's how they are. Each of them wants to be in charge, you know?
Well, it's probably just the hunger talking. We all get a little testy. We'll fix that shortly. And Lee, don't worry your head about them bandits. I'm sorry you've seen more violence than I'd have thought in your short time, but you all are safe here. Don't worry.
Think I'll go have a look around.
Don't wander too far. Dinner will be ready before you know it. And thank your friend Koch again for me. She and the kids are in the barn with the cow. That woman is a lifesaver.
Hey, so what happened at the camp? Did you guys find any more of those guys that hurt Mark?
We found a woman in the woods. She was talking all crazy and had a crossbow. So Danny killed her.
Holy shit. Was she one of those bandits?
I don't know. I think she was trying to tell me something. But then he just went off.
I don't like this, Lee. I still say we should go back to the motor inn where we at least know what to expect.
What were you and Kenny arguing about when I came back from the camp?
He's losing it, Lee. He comes over and starts talking about searching the barn and that these people are hiding something.
But you told him to mind his own goddamn business, right? We are guests here. We don't need to be overstaying our welcome more than we already are.
The way I see it, we just need to skip the dinner and get our food to go. But I'm starting to think your friend over there has another agenda.
Get the feeling something's going on here?
What makes you say that? What exactly happened at the camp?
It's nothing. Don't worry about it. Paranoia just getting to me a little bit.
I know what you mean. These backwoods people always give me the creeps. If you ask me, we should just get our dinner and leave.
Come on now. We don't want to be rude.
I'm gonna go check things out.
Just don't get too nosy. These kinds of people are usually pretty protective of their privacy.
Thank you.
It's okay, Clementine. You can pet her.
It's okay. Go ahead.
Ugh, man.
Whoa. Katja says Mabel could have her baby tonight.
We'll see, Clementine.
What's this thing?
Daddy said it's called a salt lick.
Yeah, but don't lick it. It's gross.
Did you lick it?
I don't know.
Have I missed anything?
No, not really. It smells funny in here.
Like manure.
What's manure?
Duty.
Duty. She said kids. Duty.
Here, Clementine.
My hat! You found it! I knew you'd find it. You said you would.
Listen, did you give your hat to anyone?
No.
Did you see any strangers around the motor inn who might have taken it?
No. Why?
It's probably nothing. Just let me know if you ever see anything like that.
Okay, I will. Hey, Lee. Do you think you'll ever have kids?
I'd like to someday. Maybe a little girl like you.
That's nice. You'd be a good daddy. Well, thanks for finding my hat.
You're welcome, Clem.
Do you want to pet the cow with me?
Nah, but you go on. How do you like that cow, Clem?
She's pretty.
She looks skinny. Hey there, Andy.
Yep.
We met this woman up in the woods. She seemed to know your brother.
He probably talks a little more than he ought to.
When do you think, we might eat?
Hungry, huh? Don't worry. Mama's cooking up some good grub.
How's the cow?
Well, better now we got Doc on the case.
Thanks.
Yep.
Just stay close to your mom for now.
Okay.
Empty. Looks like a bunch of old dirty clothes. Ooh, smells pretty foul.
Move.
It's a feeding trough. Just some fence posts.
Found it too, huh?
Lee, they're hiding something behind this door.
What are you up to, Snoop?
They got boxes of stuff. Something metal and sharp.
Don't get paranoid.
It's my job to be paranoid, Lee. I got my whole family on this farm right now. How about you? What about Clem?
I'll protect her no matter what.
I know you will. But look, that guy with Katya, what's his name? He locked it up real tight the second we came in. I definitely heard a noise back there, Lee.
What?
My point is, we gotta know for sure. So go find a hammer or something, and I'll have this thing off in a second. You back me up in case them farmers come running.
Hang on, man. Think this through. You smash the lock. Then what if it turns out you're wrong? You just fucked your chance to get a good meal in those kids you're trying to protect. Use your head, Kenny.
All right, Professor. What'd you have in mind?
Let me have a look at what we're dealing with first.
Hey, Lee. You know how to pick a lock, right?
No. Why would you say that?
Well, you're, you know, urban.
Oh, you are not saying what I think you're saying.
Jesus, man, I'm from Florida. Crazy shit just comes out of my mouth sometimes. Sorry. What?
See those screws? Instead of breaking the padlock, we can just take off the assembly, have a peek inside, and then replace it all again like nothing ever happened.
All right. Sounds like you got a plan. I'll hang around and keep an eye on that guy with the cow.
Andy.
Shit, I thought that was Danny. Whatever.
Can I help you boys find something?
What's behind this door, Andy?
Just tools. We keep it locked so the people in the woods don't try and grab them. We'd be dead without them. Hey, do me a favor. Don't fuck around with this door, okay? Just, you know, Mama gets nervous.
Andrew, I need your help again.
No problem. Right away, Doc.
So, how does a woman like yourself run this whole place?
Oh, I managed just fine. Plus, I had my boys to help out. I couldn't do it without them.
This guy would be like the slowest walker in the world.
Stop you now.
The zombies walk faster.
Mom, Dad, dinner time! It's dinner time!
Okay, honey, let's get that.
Dad! Dad! Come on! eat!
Kenny, come along, honey. Kenny, come on. Don't make the children wait.
I'll make an excuse for you. Get that thing off.
Dinner time.
What the hell you got in that back room?
Look, we have food here, but Danny and I still gotta do a lot of hunting to keep everyone fed. When we catch something in the woods, we skin it and dress it back there. Mama doesn't like us to make a mess in the house. So you see, nothing to worry about.
I don't believe him. Don't believe him.
Oh, Brenda, you are an angel.
Excuse
the mess. We had to block the back door after Walker got upstairs. Don't worry. That was a while ago, and I ain't been back inside since.
Everybody sit down. I'll go get the meal. Oh! This is a delight.
I could eat a horse.
Where's Mark?
Now don't you worry about him. I've already brought some food up. You just let him rest.
Mind if I wash my hands first?
Bathroom's right outside in the hall. And be sure to get under your nails. You've been mucking around in the dirt all day.
All a bad feeling about this.
Walkers aren't getting through that thing. Gauze pads. Some kind of lotion. I could use a shave. First aid recently. Ugh, what is this stuff? Looks like a bunch of medical waste in here. IV tubes, saline. What would dairy farmers need with this kind of stuff? Huh, where's that cord going? What the hell?
Thank you. is Mark?
Lee. Mark. What the hell happened?
Brothers.
What the hell happened to your legs, man?
Don't eat dinner.
Sit your ass down, Lee. This lady has made you a meal.
Yeah, Lee. What's gotten into you?
He just had a start.
He can use some goddamn manners.
You're eating human meat.
That's crazy.
What the hell?
You're scaring the kids, Lee.
Lee, what the hell is wrong with you?
Don't indulge him, Lily. There's always something with this guy.
Mom, I was eating that.
What is going on?
We need to get the kids and everyone out of here. We need to go now.
Everything could have turned out okay for you folks.
He would have died anyway. We gotta think about living.
Settle down.
I've watched like the first three episodes of season one. I kind of get into the show.
We got monsters roaming around that do nothing but eat people.
If it was like this, I'd probably watch it.
To continue to rot till they eat some more. We think we can put that meat to better.
Oh, I'm gonna puke.
You're all sick. Sick in the head.
Lee, that's not a very nice thing to imply.
Well, you are.
Andy is right. We go after folks who were gonna die anyways, one way or another.
Like y'all.
Clementine, run!
Nobody's going anywhere.
We got lots of use for y'all right here.
What the fuck? The fucking what?
Put your guns down! We're walking out of here!
Don't go near my fucking family!
I don't want to die. Mommy, what did I eat?
Somebody do something!
Lee? Lee?
Ah! Hell no.
Let go of her, you son of a bitch!
Mark's coming to dinner.
Please! Someone!
Come on!
Oh! That's gotta hurt.
Open the goddamn door! You can't keep us in here! Open up! I will tear you fuckers apart with my bare hands!
We gotta find another way out of here!
You shit fucking bastards! Open this door, goddammit! I will knock the goddamn door down!
It was a person. They tried to make us eat a person.
But you didn't do it.
No.
The rest of us did, goddammit! If you hadn't dragged your feet!
Come on, Dad. Now's not the time.
Well, try to warn you, idiots.
You okay, Clementine? They didn't hurt you, did they?
Mm-mm.
Open up!
Lee, those psychos have my family, and we're stuck in a damn meat locker! We gotta get the fuck out of here!
I'm scared.
Don't be. It's gonna be okay. I'm gonna find us a way out of here.
God!
The
walker.
Dad, please.
Hmm.
Please settle down.
I'll break that damn door down.
Dad, you can't get. Easy.
Oh, God.
Dad?
No. Dad, come on. Dad! Oh, God. He stopped breathing. I think he's had a heart attack.
Shit.
Good.
Is he dead?
He's not dead! Somebody help me!
Looks dead.
If he's dead...
He's not dead!
I don't know what has to happen, Lee. Think about it.
You saw that poor bastard at the motel.
That was all right. I'll be a brief.
Lily, I'm sorry. I truly, truly am. In a few minutes, we're going to be stuck in a locked room with a 6'4", 300-pound, seriously pissed off dead guy.
Fuck you! We can bring him back! Lee!
Morning later. But right now, we have to keep him from coming back.
No! God damn it, Kenny! He's not dead!
Maybe you're right.
No, goddammit! My dad survived worse than this!
Look, Kenny, back at the drugstore when we all thought Duck was bitten, I gave him the benefit of the doubt. Maybe we should do the same now.
That was different. Duck wasn't bitten. But come on! We know this guy's not gonna make it. Remember what Ben said. Gotta destroy the brain. Come on, Lee, I'm right about this. I know you've got my back. You always do.
Goddammit, Lee, I need you! Please help me!
Come on, Dad. Come on.
You're right, Kenny. Let's get this
over. You fucking monsters! Both of you!
I don't want to see.
I'm sorry, Lily.
No, no, no!
It's the only way.
Get off me! Don't do this! No! No, no, no! Let go of me! No! Please!
Rose.
God help us.
Hey, Ryan, how's it going?
I'm sorry.
Glad you stopped by.
Don't you fucking touch me.
Clementine.
Just a warning. This is kind of graphic.
You okay?
It's got foul language.
Why?
You got a weak stomach, just you don't watch.
I'm sorry. We couldn't take that chance. You understand why we had to do this, Clementine.
So he won't turn into one of those monsters?
That's right. I know. But you gotta be strong right now. I need you to be strong. Think about something else, something hopeful.
Like what?
Getting out of here.
We're gonna get out, right? You found a way out?
I'm working on it. There ought to be an air duct behind this unit. Maybe big enough for one of us to fit through.
I don't know, Lee. Seems like a long shot.
Does the air conditioner come off?
I think I could take it off if I had something to remove the screws. The multi-tool. Of course they took it. Shit.
Maybe there's something else we could use. I've got a rock.
A rock won't help. A coin might do the trick. Do you have a coin? If we can remove these screws, the AC should come down easily.
Talk to
back
me.
At the
Don't
motel,
talk to me.
The old man said that he,
you've got to pull yourself
he had, 60 what? Cents or something
for
like that.
For your sake? So you can feel better about what you did?
For your own sake.
Right, because you fucking care so much about me.
I think I may have found a way out of here, but I need something to remove the screws on the air conditioner. If you had something I could use as a screwdriver, a coin or something.
No.
What about him? Look, I know this is a terrible time for it, but back at the motor inn, Larry mentioned something about keeping coins in his pockets.
In other words, my father's more useful to you dead than alive.
If he was alive and had the key to getting us out of here, do you think he'd keep it to himself?
What do you want? My blessing to loot his corpse?
Your permission.
Do what you have to do.
Oh, boy. Any idea which pocket he keeps his change in?
You fucking vulture.
I'm more the right pocket. My hand is how gonna keep all my change in. Right here.
Two quarters. And a dime. Just gotta remove these screws and get this unit off.
Georgia.
You got it?
Yeah. One more should do it.
Well, there's our way out, Lee.
Clementine can fit through.
Looks like it'll probably lead right into that back room.
You think you can do this?
I'm scared.
It's okay to be scared.
We need you, Clementine.
Okay.
You're gonna be fine.
What do I do when I get out?
See if you can get to the other side of that door and open it.
Didn't even get to say goodbye.
Get in here. Got an idea.
Stay here. Take care of Lily, okay?
I will.
So we got some weapons. So we got a sickle. Over here, a hay hook. Over here.
God, what's wrong with these people?
There's a mess. Taser? Which one, guys? Taser, hay hook, or the sickle? Wake up, guys. Wake up! Sickle, a hay hook, or cattle prod. It's like a taser. Taser? Works.
So what's the plan?
That dumbass is so caught up in his own rant that we could probably sneak right up on him. Just stick behind me in case anything goes down. When we get to the front, grab his gun.
Sounds good.
Okay, you ready?
Yeah,
let's do this.
Let's go.
Stay close.
Let's do it. Pumped.
Wanted to keep and killed.
I'll keep an eye on it. Be ready. ready to act when I say.
See what he's doing here.
This is my favorite part, too. When I let one think they can just walk right out, they never even look down.
Can you see?
Some fucker thinks this is a game.
Let's see what is that? Tell me what's going on.
I don't see him anymore.
Where the fuck did he go?
I don't know.
Look again. He didn't go past us. See where he is now.
Ooh, that thing hurts.
You can't have him! We need the vet!
No!
Can't! Lee, come on!
Just go. I won't be far behind.
You see?
Should I do it, guys? Should I do it?
Should I kill him? It's how the world works now. Get part of yourself so others can live.
I don't know if I can kill him. He's living.
Cannibalism is not the answer! Aren't the walkers eating enough of us?
You gotta keep me alive! If you kill me, the meat gets tainted! You can't eat it!
You're already tainted!
You ain't gonna kill me! Just like he didn't kill Jolene! You don't have what it takes! Fucking coward!
This is not how the world works now! You won't make me kill you!
Fuck you, Lee. You and Kenny murder my dad, but you leave this piece of shit alive? Fucking asshole.
Whatever.
Oh, God! Don't hurt him!
That's God's already dead.
Please, no!
Glad I didn't, because Clementine was right there. She don't need to see that. Storms like that. I'm sure there's one here. Yes, Ryan, I'll be playing all the way through season 2. Hopefully they'll come out with season 3 at some point. I don't know if they will or not, but early. They're an idiot.
They attacked us!
I knew it! I told you we couldn't trust them!
Shit! How many of them are there?
2 left.
Where?
Larry's dead! They chopped off Mark's legs and tried to feed him to us!
Shit! Is everyone else okay?
They've still got Duck and Katja in the house, and I don't know where the fuck Kenny is.
Alright, we're coming in to help.
The main gate is too dangerous. Go around the fence and see if there's a back way in. I'll keep looking for Kenny. Do you have a weapon?
I don't leave home without it. Ben, stick close. And Lee, be careful.
It's me.
I tried. Each season's a different game of her.
Just go away and leave us be. Stop right there, I mean it. I told you to stop. I told you.
I didn't stop. She shot me. She shot me.
What you do. It doesn't have to end like this.
I'll kill her, Lee.
Just let me go. And drop the stairs. Oh, it's Mark. How do you get back upstairs?
Stay back! Don't do anything stupid!
Let her go, Brenda.
Please, listen to him.
I'll do it!
Please. Enough.
He's only 30 no more.
Is that all you got, Lee? You ain't shit!
Oh, knocked his teeth out.
It's over! Fuck you! As soon as Dan and Mama get out here, you're all fucked!
Oh, his face is messed up.
I said, it's over! Just walk away! Don't you dare walk away from me, Lee! Get back here and finish this, Lee!
What do you think, guys? Should I go back there and finish him off? Go with the group. Finish him off, call group. Well, I'm doing better after. I had a couple, like, 5 more teeth pulled the other day, but... Let me know, guys. Finish them off? Or just walk away? Hey, EC, how's it going? Sorry, I go by the first person who answers in the comments, so I saved the other one. Time to go.
Hey, Lee. I'd say I'm sorry for leaving the motel unattended, but, you know.
I'm glad you showed up when you did. If you hadn't taken that shot at Andy, we might not have gotten out of there.
Were they really killing people? For food?
Yeah, they were.
That is sick. God, just... Ugh. Clementine, she doesn't know, right?
She's not stupid, Carly.
Katja managed to grab this while she was in the house. She said it was with your stuff.
Yeah. I found it while I was looking for the people who shot Mark. Do you want it?
Why don't you keep it? Sometimes it helps to have something you can document your thoughts on.
How are you doing?
I'll be fine. Just not as young as I used to be. Hon, go on ahead and give me and Lee a second. There's gonna be fallout.
For killing Lily's dad? Yeah, I would imagine so.
What do you think?
I'm with you, Kenny. We'll do what has to be done.
You're damn right. Listen, that RV back at the motor inn is just about ready to roll. I want you to come with us. I mean it.
Okay. Yeah. Come on, Clementine. Stay close.
Lee, did you have to kill those men?
I'm sorry you had to see that, but I only did it to protect us.
Because they tried to hurt us?
Yes.
Okay.
Hey, Dad. What's that noise?
Sounds like a car.
Oh, God. Not more strangers.
Don't shoot! We're here to help!
Figures.
Oh, crap! Baby, you gotta see this. It's a shitload of food and supplies back here.
This food could save all of us.
Not all of us.
Oh, boo-hoo.
Look, we don't know if these people are dead.
If they come back, then we're just monsters who came out of the woods and ruined their lives.
This stuff isn't ours. Dad, whose car is it?
Don't worry about that, Duck. It's ours now.
It's abandoned, Ducky. Don't worry.
What if it's not? Well, what if it's not abandoned? What if it is someone's?
We have to take this, Clementine. We need it to survive.
Who said it's your decision to make?
Hey, we don't have time for this shit. Like it or not, we need this food. Now get over here and open the trunk, Lee.
Survive this after all. Duck, why don't you carry this?
Okay.
Supplies?
I'll take it.
More food in here. Got a box of food here.
I'll carry it.
All right.
This hoodie looks to be about your size. Why don't you hold on to this? It might get cold.
It's not mine.
We're not like the bandits, honey. We didn't hurt anybody to get this. Understand?
I guess so.
Hey, there were some batteries in one of those boxes. I thought they might work in your camcorder. Here, you can have some too. For your walkie-talkie.
Batteries, huh? Think you can handle those?
You're not gonna let me live that down, are you? Oh, God. Lee, you're gonna wanna see this.
Oh, shit.
Thank you.
Oh, darling baby, look at you. Look at you. You need a mama, sweetheart. We won't let them bandits get you, will we? No.
Okay.
Where's your hat?
I don't know. Can you help me find it?
Sure. When did you lose it?
I had it a couple days ago.
I promise.
Oh, thinking you're safe. Sitting there acting like things are the way they used to be. The dead don't kill their own. It's the living you gotta be afraid of. The people I used to call friends. People who just... Don't worry, little girl. Bandits got their eye on that dairy. As long as they keep getting food from them, you'll be safe. I promise.
Creepy old lady. Next time on The Walking Dead.
Making is done, pal. Ain't nothing left. We gotta get the hell out of here. Lee, I need you to back me up on this.
Is this all you got?
I told you this town is tapped. Do you have any idea what we had to do to get all that? We need to leave.
There's still a whole car full of supplies. What are they complaining about?
Not much phase is going on. It's starting to add up. I need to get to the coast. Get them out of all this madness. Lily's not doing so good, huh?
We killed her dad.
We did kill her dad. Maybe people out there got things lined up. Better than us, at least. Could be folks who have all this shit figured out.
Do people get mad when they're scared?
Sometimes, yeah, they do.
This is crazy!
I'm the one keeping this group going!
We can sort this all out, all right? We can sort this out.
I'll tell you what we need to sort out. We can't let one person fuck this up for everyone else!
So all my decisions, everybody else was the majority of. Alright guys. That's it for this stream. I'll try to get another one next week probably. Maybe sooner, I don't know. Yes, the old lady got shot by one of the guys on the farm. But, yeah, we'll catch you guys catch you guys next time. Make sure you guys go check out the Wall of Sleep. The Minion Plays on YouTube. Also, the Wall of Sleep and the Minion 7D on Twitch. I stream with them pretty regularly. Go check out the Time Show. TimeShow.com. Get your gamer box. If you guys do decide to get one, let them know in the description that I sent you over there. And we will catch you guys on the next stream. Have a good night, everybody.